Today, let us talk about biomedical waste management, handling and treatment. So, what is hospital waste or biomedical waste? Biomedical waste refers to any waste which is generated while providing healthcare, performing research, and undertaking investigations or related procedures on human beings or animals where in the hospitals, clinics, laboratories or similar establishments. We all know that there are hospitals, clinics, laboratories, dispensaries, etc. where healthcare is provided and various research are going on, various investigations are performed there. So whatever waste is generated during those procedures or during healthcare providing healthcare, whatever waste is generated through human beings and the waste which comes from veterinary hospitals and slaughterhouse is also included under the category of hospital waste or biomedical waste. Now, the question arises why there is essential for us to know about the hospital waste or biomedical waste and why there is a need to take care of this hospital waste or proper disposal of hospital waste should be there. Why this is so? Because this is a potential hazard. This waste may be infectious. This can cause infection to the human beings. This can cause infection to the general public. And there can be, the waste may contain sharp, which can cause injury to the general public if it is thrown as such. And the waste may undergo fermentation, and after fermentation, this can attract the birds, flies, or animals, which can again be a potential hazard. And this can attract the rag pickers also. If not properly disposed of and thrown like the municipal waste, then this can attract the rag pickers. Now, there is a biomedical waste management rule 2016, which has been amended in 2018 and 19. And before that, we have Environment Protection Act 1986. Later on, we have Biomedical Waste Rules 1998. This Biomedical Waste 1998 rule applies to the all kind of hospitals, clinics, healthcare provider institutions, veterinary houses, slaughterhouses, etc. And this biomedical waste rules, they apply to all the persons who generate, collect, receive, store, transport, treat, dispose or handle any kind of biomedical waste. So whom this applies? To all persons who generate, collect, receive, store, transport, treat or dispose or handle any kind of biomedical waste. And a term occupier has been included under this rule. Who is occupier? Occupier means a person who is having administrative control over the institution and the premises which are generating biomedical waste. So, hospital superintendent and head of the hospital or clinic or dispensary or at PSC level, CSC level, dispensaries level, whosoever is head of that premises is responsible for proper management of biomedical waste. And this is responsibility of every occupier to have safe and proper identification, handling, storage and disposal of biomedical waste from laboratories and related healthcare facilities. Now, this waste treatment should be, how this treatment of this biomedical waste should be, the untreated biomedical waste should not be mixed with other waste. In hospital, we can have the waste which is generated in hospital per person per bed is approximately 1 to 2 kg per person per bed per day. Clear? Out of which 15% is hazardous waste, whereas rest 85% is non-hazardous or non-infectious waste. So that can go into municipal waste. So we have to take care that this biomedical waste should not be mixed with other type of waste which is generated in the hospital. And this biomedical waste shall be segregated into the container or the bag at the point of generation. Remember, at the point of generation, where the waste has been generated, that should be segregated at that place only. This is not that we will collect all kind of waste in a bag and then we will go to a common area and there we will segregate the waste. No, this should be segregated at the point of generation. So you must have seen various color-coded bags in the wards, OPDs, hospitals, clinics, dispensaries, vaccine rooms, OPDs, etc., where whatever waste is generated, that is thrown into different type of color-coded bag. And biomedical waste container or bag should be prominently labeled with the biohazard symbol. And untreated biomedical waste must not be stored more than 48 hours. Its disposal should be within 48 hours and ensure that no spillages occur during handling or transit of biomedical waste. What can be the steps in waste management? Our aim should be to reduce in volume. We should reduce in volume the hospital waste. And segregation, which is the important step in hospital waste management or biomedical waste management, the most important step is segregation. What is segregation? To separate them at the point of generation. Then storage, proper storage should be there, and proper transportation to the designated place, and thereafter from that to final place where treatment has to be done of biomedical waste, so that it should be transported there for final disposal. Now there are various color-coded bags which you must have seen in the hospitals. These are red bag, yellow bag, blue and white translucent. So what should be kept in the red bag? Contaminated recyclable waste should be disposed of in the red bag. What are these waste? These are tubings, various tubings, IV tubings, etc. we are using in the hospitals or wards. Various glucose bottles or this nutritional bottles are used. They should be discarded into this. Then IV tubings, IV sets, catheters, urine bags, syringes without needle, and vacutainers and gloves. All these are plastic items. They are recyclable one. If we will not dispose of them properly, then there are chances of their recyclation. They can be recycled. So all these things should be put in the red bag, and plastic petri plates which are containing infectious material, they should be pre-treated by autoclaving and thereafter they should be discarded in red bag. We are using plastic petri dishes to grow the microorganism in our laboratory, and thereafter these are disposable one, so we throw them after once they are used, so they should also be thrown in the red bags. Now, blue box, or there should be container which have been having blue colored marking. These are puncture and leak proof boxes. These are puncture proof and leak proof boxes. And in these type of bags, what we can discard? Glasswares, broken or discarded glass, including medicine vials and ampoules. As these are sharp one, so they can cause harm if they are not properly disposed of. And broken or discarded contaminated glass, they are also should be disposed of in the blue bags. Cytotoxic waste should not be included in this. Now, translucent white box. This should be puncture proof, leak proof, tamper proof. Sharp waste which has been used, discarded and contaminated metals sharp, like needles, syringes with fixed needles, needles from tip, needles they first should be cut from the needle cutter, or they should be burned and they should be cut with the needle cutter, thereafter they should be thrown in this translucent white box, scalpels, blade and any other contaminated shark, all these should be disposed of in the translucent white box. Now, yellow bag. Human anatomical waste or any animal body parts, animal tissues obtained from veterinary houses, and soiled waste means items which are contaminated, potentially contaminated with blood or body fluid, like dressings, cotton swabs, bags containing residual blood or blood component, they should be discarded in the yellow bag. Chemical waste, chemicals which have been used in production of biological, they should also be discarded in yellow bag. Microbiology, biotechnology or any other clinical laboratory waste, that should be discarded in yellow bag, because all these are potentially infectious one. But we should take care that before discarding in the yellow bag, they should be autoclaved in order to make them microorganism free. Autoclaving is required. Then blood bags, laboratory cultures, stocks or a specimen of microorganism, live vaccine, attenuated vaccines if they are of expiry date, human culture or animal cell cultures. So first, before discarding in the yellow bag, they should be subjected for autoclaving in order to kill any live microorganism if it is there. Then it should be discarded in the yellow bag. Discarded linen contaminated with blood or body fluid, including masks and bed sheets, etc., they should also be discarded in the. Now, this is the biohazard symbol, and all these bags, despite of their colors, they should have this symbol over them. So this shows that this is a biomedical waste bag, and labeling of biomedical waste should be done like this: category number, quantity of waste, sender name, phone number and date of generation, receiver name, which day, which month, which year and whom to contact. So this is what biomedical waste symbol. Now, while doing disposal, what precaution we should take? All those medical, paramedical personnel who are handling biomedical waste, they should be vaccinated by hepatitis B vaccine. And they should use heavy duty gloves, apron, mask, boot while dealing with the infectious waste. Recapping of needles should be discouraged. In case if unavoidable, then single-handed method should be used. Segregation of biomedical waste and safe disposal is a prerequisite. Now, you must have seen all these kind of devices in the hospitals. So they are used for handling biomedical waste: trolleys, wheelbarrows, such type of they can. So once the waste is inside the container, the containers are transported to the designated site in such type of vehicles, and they should be kept like this at the point of generation. They should be kept like this, and trolleys handling biomedical waste should be there in the hospitals. Now, see the practices. Such type of practices should be discouraged. Why? Because he is carrying the waste in an open bag and from a crowded area where a patient are living. So these type of practices should be avoided. Whereas such type of practices, see, he has all the PPE, mask, gloves, boots, etc. And secure sealed containers bag should be used for transportation. So such type of practices should be in. Now, for transportation, untreated biomedical waste should be transported in specially designated vehicles or trolleys which have covered wheelbarrow. Manual loading should be avoided as far as possible, and bags or containers containing biomedical waste should be tied before transportation. And Before transportation, the document should be signed by a doctor or nurse in charge of the ward or that particular facility. And a special vehicle must be used to prevent assist direct contact with the transportation operator or a scavenger and the public. Now, again, you must have such type of vehicle in our college premises. Hospital waste management this vehicle or biomedical waste vehicle or ambulance. The transport container should be properly enclosed. Driver must be trained regarding procedures which are followed during accidental spillage. Wash the interior of the container thoroughly, and biohazard symbol should also be painted on the trolley. Now again, see the practices. Such type of practices. He is not having any kind of PPV or protective clothing. Overloaded trolley is there. Excessive spillage is also going on. So such type of practices should be prohibited. Whereas such type of practices, you can see he is having PPE. The container is closed one. Biohazard label is also there. No spillage, no overloaded trolley. So such type of practices should be encouraged. Now, the question arises, how the waste should be treated? What are various procedures? The waste can undergo mechanical procedure like shredding, mutilation, etc. Then thermal process, we can subject them to the raised temperature in order to inactivate the microorganism. Various chemicals, they can be subjected to the various chemicals like we discard our serum tubes or blood sample containing vials or stool samples or sputum into the disinfectant, into the discarding jar which is having disinfectant. In your practical class also, we are encouraging you to discard your slide or contaminated material into the discarding jar which is having disinfectant in that. Then there are various irradiation process like UV radiation. We can subject the biomedical waste to the UV radiations in order to inactivate the microorganism. And there are various biological process also by which the waste can be treated according to the category wise. Now, chemical disinfection can be done before final disposal in form of hypochlorites or phenols. Or we have various disinfectant which we can use in our laboratory or hospitals or at the point of generation of biomedical waste. Deep burial can also be done at PSC level, CSC level, in villages, wherever there are PSC, CSC, etc. They have open space, so much open space, so deep burial can be done. Then incineration, incinerator, they are there. And they burn everything and convert the biomedical waste into ashes. So incinerator, they are having very much high temperature. So in that we can subject the biomedical waste. Especially this is for yellow bag. Yellow bag should be subjected for incineration. So everything should be will be burned and it will be converted into ashes. Autoclaving, before whatever bags we have, we can autoclave them in our facility, and thereafter they can be subjected for final disposal. Microwaving, hot air oven or microwaving can be done. Again, high temperature of 160 degrees centigrade for 1 hour is applied in order to make the microorganism free. Inertization, in this cement or any such type of any other material is mixed with the biomedical waste in order to make them non-toxic or to reduce their toxicity. Remember one thing, for liquid waste, whenever we are discarding liquid waste, first that should be disinfected by mixing disinfectant, then they should be flushed. So liquid waste always should be disinfected first and thereafter they should be flushed. Now, what are various mechanical processes? These are used to change the physical form or the characteristic of waste. To facilitate the waste handling or to process the waste in conjunction with other treatment steps, these are compaction, shredding, as we do for disposable syringes. Disposable syringes, they are subjected to the shredder, which makes various parts or shredding is done for syringes. So small small plastic parts, syringe will be converted into small plastic parts. Thereafter this final disposal is done, or landfill or burial can be done after mechanical in compaction. There is compressing the waste into container to reduce its volume. Shredding, this includes granulation, grinding, pulping, and this is used to break the waste into smaller pieces. As I told you, for syringes this is done, shredding. Health and safety reason and good practice prohibit compacting, shredding untreated medical waste because of concern of aerosoling or spilling of microorganisms. So usually these practices are avoided because of aerosolization or spillage of microorganism. However, there are no ill effect if waste is shredded after it has been decontaminated in order to make it unrecognizable. So for syringes, what we do, first we immerse them in hypochlorite solution. We suck hypochlorite inside the syringe, then we dispose of them into the discarding jar containing hypochlorite. Thereafter we subject them into a sieve in order to remove hypochlorite, and thereafter they are subjected for shredding. Now, sanitary and secured landfilling, deep burial of human anatomical waste when the facility of proper incineration is not available. So I told you that at PSC level, CSC level, where no facility of incineration is available, then deep burial of these waste can be done. But before deep burial, that should be autoclaved, hydroclaved or microwaved. And disposal of sharp item, if they are there, again they can be subjected for landfilling. And incineration as, that should also be subjected for landfilling. Now the question arises, how to do deep burial? There should be a pit for deep burial. How much depth? 2 meter depth of that pit should be there, and fill the waste up to 1 meter from the bottom. If 2 meter pit is there, only half of that pit should be filled with the waste, not the complete. Thereafter, that waste should be covered with a lime, 50 centimeter layering of lime is done. Thereafter, galvanized iron or wire mesh at the top should be there and secure the area. These are different color coded bag, yellow, red, white and blue, and already I told you which type of biohazard should be subjected into them. And treatment is, yellow bag should be subjected for incineration or deep burial. If facility of incineration is not there, then it should be subjected for deep burial. Red bags, autoclaving, microwaving, hydroclaving or rice. White bag, these should be shredding, mutilation, encapsulation, and blue, of course, after disinfection, they should be sent to the recycling. Now, conclusion is, cleaning and disinfecting environmental surface is fundamental in reducing healthcare associated infection, and for that we should use various cleaning strategies. Proper use of PPE should be there, those who are handling biomedical waste, and the biomedical waste should be handled as biomedical waste management rules. And we can say that first rule in medicine or nursing is primum non nocere, means first do no harm. If we want to prevent hospital infections, or if we want to avoid healthcare associated infections or nosocomial infections, then this is our duty to properly handle the biomedical waste, and proper disposal of that should be, because if we can't give relief to the patient, then we should do no harm to the patient also. And thank you very much for patience listening.